Hello everybody, myself Suresh Naidu, Selection Grade Lecturer, Mechanical Department, Government Polytechnic, Ballari. I'll be handling Strength of Materials for third semester Mechanical Engineering. First, we'll learn about simple stress and strain, which is the Unit 1. In this chapter, first we'll come to know about introduction, type of external loads or force, which is indicated by P, stress, which is indicated by F, type of stresses, strain, which is indicated by small e, and type of strains. You know that engineer come across certain material in his daily life and projects. The materials like steel of different shapes and sizes, angles of iron, circular bar, cement, etc., which are used in his project. While selecting a suitable material for his project, an engineer is always interested to know its strength. The strength of the material may be defined as the ability to resist its failure and behavior under the action of external force. It has been observed that under the action of these forces, the material is first deformed and then its failure takes place. A detailed study of forces and their effects, along with some suitable protective measures for safe working condition, is known as strength of materials. Next, we'll come to know about types of external loads or forces. One is tensile load, compressive load, shear load, bending load, and torsion load. When a body is subjected to two pulls, which is as shown in the figure, then the body tends to increase its length, is known as tensile load. Compressive load, when a body is subjected to two opposite pushes, as a result of which it tends to decrease its length, is known as compressive loads. Shear load, when a body is cut across by a section of two equal parallel tangential opposite forces, which is as shown in the figure. Here we have two opposite equal parallel forces acting against a resisting body. Bending load, it is the load applied on a body to bend or make a curvature. This is a bar, a load P is applied, making a curvature as dotted line as shown. Torsional load, the load applied on a body to twist is called torsion load. Stress, this is very important. Here, whenever a body is loaded, it gets deformed to a certain limit. This deformation is resisted by the internal forces set up in the body. The internal resistance set up in the body due to applied external force per unit cross section is called stress. Stress is defined as force per unit area. Mathematically, stress is equal to load applied P cross sectional area. Here we take load applied P because
the resisting force R is equal to the load applied P
when the body is in equilibrium. To understand it more clear, let us take a bar which is subjected to two opposite pulls. When we cut at a section X, the body to be in equilibrium, the applied load P is equal to resisting force R of the left side and similarly to the right side. And therefore, the applied load P will equal to resistance R. Hence, we can write it in mathematically as stress is equal to load P divided by cross-sectional area, that is equal to F is equal to P by A. You know that force units is Newton and area is mm square. Here the cross section of this rectangular bar is a, if this is B, if this is T, then it is B into T, and if this is L, okay? If it is a circular cross section, it is pi by 4 D square. Now let us come to type of stresses. Tensile stress, compressive stress, shear stress, thermal stress, bearing stress. Tensile stress. When a body is subjected to two opposite pulls, as shown in the figure, as a result of which it increases its length, the stress induced is called tensile stress. Tensile stress, F is equal to load by area. Its units are Newton per mm square or Newton per meter square. Compressive stress, when a body is subjected to two equal and opposite pushes, as shown in the figure, as a result of which it decreases its length. The stress induced is called compressive stress, which is as shown in the figure. F is equal to P by A, that is equal to Newton per mm square. Shear stress. When a body is subjected to two equal and opposite forces acting across a resisting section as shown in the figure A, as a result of which it tends to shear as shown in figure B, the stress induced is called shear stress. Here, shear stress is equal to applied load by resisting cross-sectional area. When bearing stress, when one object presses against another, it refers to bearing stress. Here, when an object resists on another object, the in-between, we call it as bearing stress at contact surface. Strain. Whenever a body is loaded, its dimension changes. When one end is fixed and the another end is loaded, we see that its length increases. It is defined as change in length by original length. Type of strains, linear strain, lateral strain, volumetric strain and shear strain. Linear strain, the strains that takes place along the axis or along the applied load is called linear strain. In this we have tensile strain and compressive strain. Lateral strain is the strain that is taking place perpendicular to the applied load, the deformations, then we call it as lateral strain. Now let us learn in detail. Yes, now linear strain. Linear strain is change in length to original length in direction of applied load, that is equal to E linear is equal to change in length by original length. Lateral strain. In this, we have tensile strain and compressive strain. It is the ratio of change in original length in the direction of applied load. Compressive, it is the ratio of change in length by original length in the direction of applied load. Lateral strain, as I have earlier explained that the strain which is at right angles perpendicular to the applied load is known as lateral strain. Here when you apply a load, the length increases. Here you can see that the breadth and thickness decreases, and it is at an angle, how many? 90 degrees to the applied load. Therefore, it is called lateral. Lateral strain is change in breadth by original breadth. This is change in breadth by original breadth and change in thickness by original thickness. For cylinders, bar, then the lateral strain is change in diameter by original diameter. Volumetric strain, it is the ratio of change in volume to original volume. This kind of situation comes across when a body is immersed in a water where the forces are acting in all the dimension, or the volume is affected. Therefore, volume changes. Therefore, volumetric strain is change in volume by original volume. Shear strain, it is defined as the ratio of lateral displacement. It is defined as the ratio of lateral displacement between two layers. When we take a layer at a distance of L, when we apply a force in the direction, the layer B, C get displaced by a distance B dash, C dash at a distance of delta L, and the distance between them is L, then tan theta is equal to delta L by L, where delta theta is very small, neglecting tan, therefore we get theta is equal to delta L by L. Thank you. If you have any doubts, you can ask or text me. Thank you very much.